Christ be beside me, Christ be before me, Christ be behind me, King of my heart. Christ be within me, Christ be below me, Christ be above me, never to
You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Your sister, who intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servant, mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The children of Israel set out from Elim and came into the desert of Sin, which is between Elim and Sinai, on the 15th day of the second month, after their departure from the land of Egypt. Here in the desert, the whole assembly of the children of Israel grumbled against Moses and Aaron. The children of Israel said to them, "Would that we had died at the Lord's hand in the land of Egypt, as we sat by our flesh pots and ate our fill of bread. But you have to lead us into the desert to make the whole community die of famine." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I will now rain down bread from heaven for you. Each day the people are to go out and gather their daily portion. Thus will I test them, to see whether they follow my instructions or not. On the sixth day, however, when they prepare what they bring in, let it be twice as much as they gather on the other days." Then Moses said to Aaron, "Tell the whole congregation of the children of Israel, present yourselves before the Lord, for he has heard your grumbling." When Aaron announced this to the whole assembly of the children of Israel, they turned toward the desert, and lo, the glory of the Lord appeared in the cloud. The Lord spoke to Moses and said, "I have heard the grumbling of the children of Israel. Tell them, in the evening twilight you shall eat flesh, and in the morning you shall have your fill of bread, so that you may know that I, the Lord, am your God. In the evening, quail came upon and covered the camp. In the morning, a dew lay all about the camp. And when the dew evaporated, there on the surface of the desert were fine flakes like hoar frost on the ground. On seeing it, the children of Israel asked one another, 'What is this?' For they did not know what it was. But Moses told them, 'This is the bread which the Lord has given you to eat.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Respond, O your song, The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
They tempted God in their hearts by demanding the food they craved. Yes, they spoke against God, saying, "Can God spread a table in the desert?"
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
Yet he commanded the skies above, and the doors of heaven he opened. He rained manna upon them for food and gave them heavenly bread.
The Lord gave them bread
from heaven. Man ate the bread of angels, food he sent them in abundance. He stirred up the east wind in the heavens, and by his power brought on the south wind.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven,
and he rained meat upon them like dust, and like the sand of the sea, winged fowl, which fell in the midst of their camp, round about their tents.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The seed of the word of God Christ is the sower, and all who come to him will live forever.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On that day, Jesus went out of the house and sat by the sea. Such large crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat down. And the whole crowd stood along shore, and he spoke to them at length in the parable, saying, "A sower went out to sow, and as he sowed, some seed fell on the path, and the birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky ground, where it had little soil. It sprang up at once, because the soil was not deep, and when the sun rose, it was scorched, and it withered for lack of roots. Some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. But some fell in rich soil and produced fruit, 100, or 60, or 30-fold. Whoever has ears, all to hear." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord
Jesus concludes the parable of the sower with this warning: whoever has ears ought to hear. Whoever has ears ought to hear. How well do we hear? How good is our hearing? A story is told of a man who feared that his wife wasn't hearing as well as she used to, and he thought she might need a hearing aid. Not quite sure how to approach her, he called a family doctor to discuss the problem. The family doctor gave him a simple, informal test that a husband could perform to give the doctor a better idea about the hearing loss of his wife. "Here's what you do," the doctor said. "Stand about 30 feet away from her, and in normal conversational speaking tone, see if she hears you. If not, go to 20 feet, then 10 feet, and so on until you get a response." That evening, the wife was in the kitchen cooking dinner, and he was in the den. And so he said to himself, "I'm about 30 feet away from her. Let's see what happens." So in a normal tone, he said, "Honey, what's for dinner?" No response. So the husband moved across to the kitchen, to the dining room, where he was now about 20 feet from his wife, and asked again, "Honey, what's for dinner?" Still, he got no response. So now he walked up to the kitchen door itself, and was about 10 feet away from her, and asked, "Honey, what's for dinner?" Again, there was no response. So now he walked right up behind her, and now was close to her, and said, "Honey, what's for dinner?" "Ralph," she responded, "for the fourth time, chicken." So we also need to ask ourselves, how good is our hearing? When we do not hear the response from God, is it possible that it is us who are deaf and not God who is silent? Is God speaking loud and clear like this woman was, but for some reason, like the husband, I cannot hear? You see, God is speaking to us all the time, like the sower who sows the seed everywhere. It's up to the ground to receive the seed, just as it is up to us, our ears, to hear and receive God's word. That's why Jesus says, whoever has ears ought to hear. Perhaps we have some hearing impediment and can't receive God's word well. Like the seed on the rocky ground without soil to nourish it, or that fell on the thorny among thorns that scorched it. I have some three friends who have some hearing impediment in different ways. The first one is a 75-year-old woman who has lost much of her hearing, and so she uses a hearing aid. This device has different settings, one for the phone, one for ordinary conversation, and the lowest volume she reserves for her husband. Do we turn off our hearing aid also when God is speaking to us, or turn down the volume like this woman so as not to hear? My second friend is an older gentleman. He has lost some hearing in one ear, but he's a stubborn mule and he refuses to get a hearing aid. So when they go out to dinner with his wife is forced to sit on the side of the good ear. Don't we sometimes, like my friend here, also refuse the aids God gives us to hear the sacraments and his word, because we are happy with the little that we have already? My third friend is a teenager, and her hearing works just fine. But often, I will hear her telling her mother, "Mom, I hear you, but I'm not listening." This teenager perhaps is us, that sometimes nothing is stopping us from hearing or listening to God. Our ears work just fine, but we choose not to hear. My dear friend, Jesus is telling us today, whoever has ears, let him or her hear. Our ears have been cleansed through baptism. By baptism, we are now being given the power to hear God's word and to act upon it. We have no excuse. We have spiritual ears that can hear. Let us use them to hear what God has to tell us. We turn to God, the giver of all good things, to present our petitions. For the check on her journey of faith, may God's word guide and nourish her. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for those who lead nations and communities, called shepherd God's people, may the Spirit of the Lord lead them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for those who hunger and those who produce the harvest, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for our own faith community, may God bless our gathering this day to be fed in word and sacrament. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
For the faithful departed, called home at the end of their faith journey, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intention of this Mass and for our personal intentions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayer. Lord God, hear our prayers this day as you lead us on our journey to your eternal presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Accept, we pray, the sacrifice of your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, what each has offered to the honor of your majesty, the benefit and salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your
heart.
Lift up your heart. Lift up your heart.
It
is true and just our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God, for though you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our prayers add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord, and so in company with the choir of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, 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 holy God.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. We are holy, therefore, this is to pray by sending down your spirit upon them like they do fall, for them become for us the body and blood of our Lord. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, and gave his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended,
this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, when we eat,
proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Our son also pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed John, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be prepared to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and with the help of your mercy, and the rescue from sin, and save from all distress as we await the present hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of Jesus, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look on our sins from the feet of your church, which has to grant her peace and live in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Pass off my tell of the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Of the sins of the world. Blessed are those called the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest enter my house, but only say the word, and my soul
Thank you. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people with prayer, Lord, and lead those who endure the heavenly mysteries to pass from our ways to new to life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel.
Upon you, may you always, the Father, the Son,